Protesters who are at the Montebello summit this week in Quebec are accusing police of spying on them, and they say they have proof. Protesters claim this footage shows three undercover police agents, the three men whose faces are covered with bandanas, trying to provoke violent confrontations. Protesters suspect the masked men were members of the Quebec police force. They accused the three of deliberately trying to provoke a riot to give the uniformed officers an excuse to arrest the group. The masked men, their identities not known. Quebec police are not commenting on the accusations. Joining us now is Dave Coles. He's president of the Communications, Energy and Paper Workers Union of Canada. Sir, why is the union involved in this?
Well, we were there along with a number of other groups from civil society to deliver a message to the two presidents and our prime minister. We were there with the Council of Canadians to deliver 10,000 petitions saying that we were opposed to the manner in which the SPP was being handled.
Mm-hmm.
Later on in the day, a number of us, our families and children, were between some peaceful demonstrators that were sat down in front of the police. They didn't want to move, and we were concerned that these young men and women were going to be attacked by the police, and so we put ourselves between them and the police and had been there for a number of hours to ensure that these young people were able to exercise their democratic right. And what happened a number of times, some of the younger people would come up and attempt to confront the police, and I was able to talk them back, saying that this was a peaceful demonstration, that these young people were there, and it was our job to ensure that nothing harmful happened to them. Now, what then happened is these three people, you can tell they're not young children, they're in their 40s or so, were being chased by some of the demonstrators, and they were yelling at, the demonstrators were yelling at them that they were provocateurs and they were police. And they started to come towards the police line that we were protesting at. I confronted them. I asked them to stop, to leave, that they should put the rocks down that they had in their hands and show their faces. If they really wanted to protest, if you're really protesters, you should put your masks down and show us who you are. You got to remember, we're all dressed like this, right? We're a really dangerous lot here. They refused to do that. I accused them of being police, and every time I yelled at them that they were in fact police, you know, you could see by their facial expressions they were deeply troubled. They started to push me and some of my family and our staff around. And they forced their way right up to the line. And there's where it gets really suspicious. They were politely let through the line by the security forces and thrown to the ground. Well, what happens is that a number of people took pictures of it, and these three provocateurs are wearing police boots. You can see clearly in the still photographs, it's the same brand, the same pattern. They're the same boots. You know, well, too well-fed, too good a shape. These aren't young kids off the street. These people were there to deliberately cause trouble, to give the police a chance or an opportunity to try to get rid of these young kids that were exercising their democratic right by protesting peacefully, Gandhi style, sitting down in the middle of the road.
Mm. Now, Mr. Coles, no one knew who these guys were, though. No one came up to you and say, I know who they are. I've seen them before.
No, they haven't. We anticipate now that we have at least one or two very clear shots of their face, that someone is going to come forward and tell us who they are. I've been around the peace movement and the labor movement all my life. And I can just tell you empirically for myself, these guys are cops or agents for them.
Mounties?
I don't know. Those are the questions that we want to ask the Prime Minister and the Premier of Quebec. I mean,
you know what's odd here, sir? You know what's odd is these guys, looking at this video, absolutely look like cops in drag. I mean, they certainly look like cops, and they stand out in your crowd, you know, like a sore thumb.
Absolutely.
What kind of senior intelligence police officer is going to assign three burly middle-aged men to wear, you know, these funky outfits and try to blend in when it's not going to happen? It doesn't look like this was, you know, at the highest levels of anything.
Well, I got to tell you, the PMO's office got caught before. You remember the APEC inquiry directly related to what was going around a protest. I mean, my own personal opinion, I'm not so sure all of those that hang out in the PMO's office are all that bright anyway.
What's your next move, sir?
Well, we've asked a number of questions of the government, of both Canada and the Premier of Quebec. We're going to send a letter to both of those individuals tomorrow. We want answers. This is extremely important to Canadians. You've got to remember, this is an international conference, and you know the security of the President of the United States is at risk, as so is the President of Mexico. You would think that they would be taking this serious.
Mr. Coles, do you have anybody representing any police force on your side? Has anyone come up to you say, we're going to find who these guys are?
No, we haven't. A number of the media are posting their pictures asking who they are. I mean, just think about this. There's four people we know that are arrested, two men and two women. Apparently, the Council of Canadians knows specifically who they are. All right, where are these other three? We saw them, so did the media, hauled away. Were they arrested? What were their names? If they were arrested, were they charged? Are they in Guantanamo Bay now? I mean, there's a whole number of very serious questions that I think that Canadians have the right to know.
Your confidence must be pretty high, though, that sometime soon you will know who these three are.
Absolutely. I think that there is enough people out there investigating this that we're going to find out. I mean, what's really a shame here is that this breach of Canadian democracy actually hides the whole issue of why we were there. I mean, we're there because citizens have a real problem with the SPP. And this way, Stephen Harper gets to once again dodge the questions. He doesn't, you know, not forced to say what's going on here. I think it's important to Canadians, particularly to our members, you know, to get answers to a whole number of questions. Particularly around our security.
Yeah. Dave Coles, good luck to you, sir.
Great. Thank you very much for your time.
You.